Pavan Bnb is the ambassador of 1,20,000 rupees.
She is not clever.
1,20,000 rupees.
I request all the prize winners to come on the dais with a good photograph.
We are here with the winner of the Mumbai Mayor's Cup B category, Pavan Bnb. Pavan, you're holding this glittering trophy and you won 1,20,000 rupees. What's the feeling like?
The feeling is amazing because it's my maiden national championship and I'm feeling very happy at this moment.
Pavan, tell us, what do you do? You are a coach, right?
Yeah, I'm not a seasoned player actually. And last time I played was 2 years ago. And somehow I managed to play this tournament. And I'm very happy.
Well, usually when you have these age group category event, these rating events, yeah, they are so keenly contested that a player who is not in touch or not playing will often, you know, be relegated to the back. But you finished right at the top. How does that work?
No, this tournament I kept saying myself that, I mean, result doesn't matter. You have to just go and play, enjoy the game. So basically, I'm one among the top seeds. Like my seeding was 12th. So I know these below rating tournaments are always tough. Like when it comes to lower games against lower rated, they won't give that easily. So what I decided, okay, whatever happens, you have to hang on there. And somehow I managed to get it.
And what were the most important things that you did during the event or during the game in between the rounds that helped you?
So from the past 7-8 years, I'm into professional training. I train my students. So first time in my life, I think what I tell my students, I just followed it. So every time I tell them, like, you have to sit, don't look here and there, and don't get up, and play slowly. See the first moves first, and see your opponent's last moves idea. Surprisingly, I mean, I managed to do all this every round. I not even got up once. I mean, just for fun also. Like, if I had to use a washroom, okay, that's an excuse. But I didn't get up and I didn't see any other board. I was just focusing on my table.
Fantastic. Usually, people say that coaching affects your game in a bad way. As a player, you kind of deteriorate. Do you think that's true?
See, if you have the willpower, anything is possible. That's what I believe in. Before coming to this tournament, even I have some doubts, like, is it possible for me to finish in top 10 and all? But anyway, as I told you before, I'm just playing for enjoy the game. So I think that keeps me motivated. Like, if you enjoy the game, you can do it.
So now you played, you won here. So you're a player and you're also a coach. What do you enjoy more?
See, as a player, if you want to really grow, you need some that financial support and all. You need proper resources, like a coach, you need proper training, and you need to have a rating tournaments and all. In 2008-09, where I'm playing my best in chess, I don't have any of those opportunities that time. Maybe
your highest rating was somewhere in the 2000s, yes?
2003, yeah. So, I mean, okay. So, at one point of time, I had to choose between as a coach or a player. But obviously, if you want to survive in chess, you have to be a coach. That's the only way you get money. So, in the middle, I'm just managing the tournaments here and there. That's it.
So how did you manage when you were in this phase in 2008-09? You said that in order to survive, you had to coach. So what did you
do? So basically, I used to do part-time and I used to do my master's also, like post-graduation. I'm a software engineer actually. I gave up the profession and I'm into chess because I love chess. So I'm into this. So I need to manage both. I have to manage my studies and I need to manage my coaching and I need to manage my tournaments, my games as well. Those days I couldn't play much. I still regret, but at least now I'm doing in coaching in chess, so I'm at least involved with that 64 squares.
So you work with this academy called SMC?
Yeah, South Mumbai Chess Academy.
How has your experience been as a coach over there?
Before coming to SMCA, I have some achievements here and there, but after coming to SMCA, I learnt a lot and I was able to give service to some of the best students over the past 5 years. We have some champions under 7, under 9, and some world medals also. It's been good learning. It's always a learning process, the coaching and playing both.
So last question, if there is some ambitious player who is always confused about whether to play in B group and win a lot of prize money because he's in need of money, or to play in A group and try to improve his game, what would you recommend?
Maybe you can take my example. I can't judge people on that, but my personal experience is that if you are interested and if you want to play, both are same, like A group or B group. For me, I had to choose between A and B. I went to play B because I am playing after a long time. I just want to test myself ki where I stand. I mean, if I play after a long time, what is going to happen? What is the worst that can happen to me? I just want to check it. And somehow, of course, I missed one or two, games here and there. I mean, I missed some losses and I missed some wins. I couldn't convert. But end of the day, okay, I'm quite happy with my performance.
Thank you so much, and we wish you good luck in both coaching and playing.
Thank you. Thank you so much.